Welcome, everybody. This is Justine Turner, and we are coming to you live from the Whittemore Center at the University of New Hampshire in Durham, New Hampshire. Tonight is New Hampshire's Raising the Bar meet, where they will try to break the attendance record in a huge quad meet versus the University of Bridgeport Purple Knights, the Temple University Owls, and Eagle Conference opponents, the University of Pittsburgh Panthers. The Wildcats are coming off their home opener on Sunday, where they pulled out a victory over the University of Iowa Hawkeyes with a 193.95. New Hampshire was led by senior Aaron Carroll, who had another stuck vault to score a 9.825 for the vault title and Eagle Specialist of the Week honors. Senior Danielle Mulligan came away with the bars title with a score of 9.875 and an individual all-around win, and junior Emma Weiner was victorious on floor with a 9.85, tying her career high. The Wildcats also had big performances from their freshman class, highlighted by Hannah Baddock's 9.775 on beam and Haley Louise's 9.775 on bars. New Hampshire will be looking to hit 24 for 24 in an attempt to score a season-high team score tonight in front of their big home crowd and get a win over three strong opponents. For Bridgeport, the Purple Knights are coming off of a quad meet with Yale, Rutgers, and Southern Connecticut, where they were narrowly beat by Yale by less than a tenth of a point. Bridgeport came away with a team score of 193.75, led by all-arounder Juliana Rowland, who placed second with a 38.625, and top scorer on floor, Maya Reimers, with a 9.8. Bridgeport will need to make small adjustments in their routines to get more 9.8 and above scores to try and pull out a win. The Temple University Owls are coming off of a tri-meet against Penn State and Towson. Temple had a strong showing, coming in second with a 194.7, highlighted by a 1-2 finish for Temple's all-arounders, Ariana Castrense and Monica Servidio, with career best for both, with a 39.15 for Castrense and a 39.05 for Servidio. Temple will need standout performances from their all-arounders again to get a victory against some strong opponents tonight. University of Pittsburgh Panthers are coming off their own quad meet as well, where they posted a strong 194.75 to come in second behind West Virginia's 195.5, but beating Utah State and Eastern Michigan. Pittsburgh was led by all-arounder Olivia Miller, who pulled out a victory in the large competition with a 39.05. The Panthers had a strong team scores on three events and will look to improve their team bar score to better overall their team score here tonight. The Wildcats coaching staff consists of UNH legend Gail Goodspeed, who is in her 40th year as head coach. Goodspeed has had much success in her years as head coach, making the postseason 37 out of her 39 seasons. She is joined by associate head coach Lindsay Brooke Ayotte, who is in her third year as associate head coach, Sunny Marshan, who is in her second year as assistant coach. Volunteer assistant coach Ed Daddy plays a huge part in team events as well, attending all practices and competitions after retiring from his full-time role as associate head coach in 2016. The Purple Knights are coached by Byron Knox, who is in his 15th year as head coach of the UB women's program. Knox has had much success in his years, highlighted by USAG Collegiate National titles every year from 2009 to 2014, and a trip to the NCAA Regional Meet in Florida in 2013, becoming only the second D2 program to make NCAAs. He is joined by Becky Ferrero. There will be six gymnasts competing on each event, and the top five scores on each event will count towards the team score. All four team event scores will make up the final team score. With four teams competing, we will try to keep you as updated as possible with scores and highlights from all four events, as all teams and events will be completing at one time. The Wildcats will start on vault, rotate to bars, beam, and finish on floor. Pittsburgh will start on bars, move to beam, floor, vault, and finish on vault. Temple will start on beam, move to floor, vault, and finish on bars. And Bridgeport will compete first on floor, move to vault, bars, and finish up on beam. Teams are finishing up their touch warm-ups, and competition will begin when the judges take control of their events. On vault for the Wildcats, we will start with senior Danielle Doolin, followed by Courtney Bondanza, Aaron Carroll, Danielle Mulligan, Nicole O'Leary, and Lauren Diggin. On bars for Pittsburgh, we will start with Sophie Bohenick, followed by Olivia Miller, Krista Collins, Rachel Dugan, and Lucy Brett. On beam for Temple, we will start with Taylor Newland, followed by Jordan Oster, Jackie Turpak, Ariana Castrense, Delaney Garnett, Garen, and Monica Servideo. And on floor for Bridgeport, we will start with Kelly Tereshko, followed by Gabby Kistner, then Kelly Acock, Juliana Rowland, Crystal Gwynn, and finish up with Maya Reimers.
Judges, please take control of your events. First up on bars, commissioner will be Sophie Lovenick. On B for Temple, Taylor Newland. On floor for Richmond, Kelly Tereshko. And on ball for UNH, Danielle Doolitt.
Judges are taking control of their events, and competition will start now. Take a look at Danielle Doolin's vault. Danielle has a career high of a 9.8. Starts with the Yurchenko layout full, done nicely. A little pike down at the end. That vault comes out a 9.95. So that is the highest Danielle will score there. Little leg separation, a little knee bend, and the slight pike and a step back. But a great start for the Cats. In bars, we are looking at Sophie Volmanek. She has a career, last week she scored a 9.725. As she finishes a nice routine for Pitt to start out on bars. Up on floor for Bridgeport is a student, Kelly Tereshko from Madison, Indiana. And last week she scored a 9.625. Looks like Beam is getting ready to get started with freshman Taylor Newland. Courtney Bondanza on vault for UNH, and she piked down that vault a little bit. Again, that starts from a 9.95, so that is the highest she can score. A nice side semi on beam for Taylor as Kelly gets ready for her last pass on floor. Like she just didn't get enough punch on that after that 1.5. An interesting dismount off beam with a back tuck full off the side. We'll get a look here at senior Erin Carroll for New Hampshire. She is coming off of Eagle Specialist of the Week honors for this vault in particular. She does a front handspring, front pike half. It is the only vault in the Wildcat lineup to start from a 10, and both meets this year so far, Erin has stuck it solid. So she is looking to do the same thing here tonight. On bars, we're going to get a look at freshman Olivia Miller from Monroeville, Pennsylvania. Last week she scored a 9.8. A nice piked Jaeger there. Had a look at Erin's vault, done beautifully, step back on the landing. Not the stick she was hoping for, but still a strong vault. Olivia finishes up a great routine on bars, a step back on her dismount, but a solid performance for the freshman. Getting ready on floor for Bridgeport is sophomore Gabby Kistner from Raleigh, North Carolina. She scored a 9.725 last week. Getting ready for Temple on beam is sophomore Jordan Oster from Perry Hill, Maryland, and she has a career high of a 9.8 on beam. And for the Wildcats on vault, It will be senior Danielle Mulligan, who is new to the vault lineup this year. She's from Farmingdale, New York, and last week she scored her career high with a 9.775. She came in a little short on the vault there. Looks like one of her hands might have slipped. So she didn't quite get the pop that she needed to make that vault all the way around. Not the start she was looking for, but as a senior, she will definitely be able to pull that around. Bars for Pittsburgh, we will be looking at senior Krista Collins. She's from Weddington, North Carolina, and she has a career high of a 9.675. Second pass for Gabby there on floor, done nicely. Front handspring, front full, front tuck. And on vault, we will be looking at senior Nicole O'Leary from Newton, Connecticut. She does a front handspring front pike. This vault starts from a 9.9, but Nicole has scored a 9.9 on this. She's capable of doing it extremely well. You'll see the height she gets, kicks it out early. She does take a step on that vault, but other than that, there are zero deductions in that vault. It is done so, so well, the best I've ever seen it done. On floor, the Purple Knights will be getting ready for senior Kelly Acock. She is from Locust Grove, California. And last week, she scored a 9.675. Over on beam, Temple will be preparing for freshman Jackie Turpak from York, Pennsylvania. And on vault, we will be taking a look at sophomore Lauren Diggin from Sinking Spring, Pennsylvania. She has a career high of a 9.85. And starting her bar routine, I believe, is Krista Collins. Big Takachev on bars. A little short on that handstand on bars. The judges will be looking for finding handstand shapes in vertical. She's a little shy of vertical on that handstand. Had her chest a little low on her dismount, but a hit routine for Pittsburgh. Looking at, again, Lauren came in kind of the same way on vault that Danielle did, where it looked like one of her hands slipped. She came in a little short. Didn't quite get the pop she was looking for. Nice front double full to start on floor. Similar to her first girl up. Didn't quite get the punch she was looking for out of the 1.5. So had to take the fall there. We'll be looking at an exhibition vault from Emma Weiner. She does a Yurchenko layout half. She has a blind landing. Also starts from 9.95. Her score, unfortunately, will not count for UNH because it is only an exhibition, but she wants to show them that she is ready to be in a lineup, and that vault is definitely one that could be in a lineup. That was done beautifully by Emma. As we look at all four teams here tonight, keep in mind that this is only the second or third meet for teams, and so they are trying to work their kinks out, figure out what lineups are going to work, and make sure that their athletes can last throughout the season. So there may be some mistakes here that they're not, hopefully not going to be making further down the road in the season. Beautiful shoot over handstand. Unfortunately, a fall on the dismount on beam. Getting ready for a dismount. Double layout. Maybe a little pop there, but her feet didn't move, so I would consider that a step landing. And a nice bar routine for Pittsburgh. Once all four teams finish their first rotation, we will be able to update you with scores from each routine. On floor, we are looking at freshman Juliana Rowland. She's from Lumberton, New Jersey, and last week she scored a 9.525. She was a standout as a freshman, competing in the all-around. Her first tumbling pass is a double pike. A little extra power on the end there, but she stayed in bounds. She gets ready for her second pass, her teammates cheering her on in the corner. An answering front layout, front full. Again, a little extra power there. The judges will be looking for athletes to show a little more control at the end there. Has the showmanship of a collegiate floor routine down already. Beautiful ginger, beautiful double tuck to finish. Bars just had a beautiful ginger, sky high. A little shy of vertical on that handstand on the low bar. Nice routine on floor for Bridgeport. Finishing up that bar, and a stuck double layout. That routine was gorgeous. I believe that was senior Lucy Brett from North Somerset, United Kingdom. And she has a career high of a 9.925, and I can see why. Both vault and bars have finished their six competitors, and beam and floor are the last two finishing up. Nice back handspring layout step out on beam, a small wobble at the end. Half. The judges will be looking for a little bit more amplitude, so height and a bigger split in that leap pass on beam. And I round off double full to finish, slight hop forward, but a step routine for Temple on beam. again. You can see so powerful, just a little bit of a hop back there. The judges are really looking for controlled landings to get those high scores. Second tumbling pass, double tuck. You see she's a little more controlled there. Having some fun with her floor choreography. That's what college floor teams are all about. That was cool. Last tumbling pass. Front handspring, front full, front layout. A great routine for Bridgeport. Overview of the scores unofficially. Obviously, there are a few events that scores haven't come in or competitors haven't finished. New Hampshire ended up with a 48.175 unofficially on vault. So they will hope to improve that team score as they move on to bars, beam, and floor. Pittsburgh finished bars unofficially with a 48.075. On floor, we are looking at sophomore Maya Reimers from New York, New York. Last week, she scored a 9.8, and she was the high scorer for Bridgeport. Starts with a big full in and a nice controlled landing. Shows you how powerful she is. Doesn't need a lot of extra momentum going into it. Jumps, wolf full, straddle full. Done nicely. Walked into that double pike and stood it up beautifully. Wonderful routine for Maya. Great way to close out their floor lineup. Looks like there was a little bit of a confusion with the lineup on beam. The judges and the coaches were trying to get that sorted out. Unofficially for Pittsburgh on bars, Sophie Bohannock started with a 9.6, followed by Olivia Miller's 9.55, Krista Collins with a 9.425, and both Rachel Dugan and Lucy Brett scoring a 9.75 for their bar teams to close out Pittsburgh's bar rotation. As Temple waits for Beam, it is never fun to have an extra long waiting time, especially before an event like Beam. This is one of those exhibition routines for Bridgeport on floor. So again, her score will not count towards the team score, but she's showing that she's ready to be in a lineup. Starts with a punch front 1.5 called a Rudy. Done very nicely. Jump series, a little out of control at the end there. Whip half front layout. Nice controlled landing there as well. As Molly gets ready for her third tumbling pass, she'll finish with a front full front tuck and a nice job as an exhibition performance. Solid floor routine. Again, Temple has a couple more girls left on Beam, but it looks like unofficially after the first rotation, New Hampshire will have a 48.175. Pittsburgh finishes with a 48.075, and Bridgeport finishes floor with a 46.825. Another look at Danielle Doolin's vault. Courtney Von Danza's vault. Taking another look at UNH's vault lineup there, you can see Danielle's hand just slipped a little bit, didn't quite get the pop she was looking for. Scores for New Hampshire on vault. Erin Carroll led the way with Nicole O'Leary led the way with a 9.8. Erin Carroll scoring a 9.75. Danielle Doolin with a 9.65. Courtney Bondanza with a 9.5. Lauren Diggin with a 9.475. And Danielle Mulligan with a 9.05. Teams are trying to stay loose and relaxed as we wait for that Beam rotation and they wait for their second rotation. Starts with a nice full turn. That is a requirement on Beam. Beautifully unique flight series, a backhand spring layout step out. She closed that second foot in and did a split jump right after. split jump, split three quarters, done nicely. Cat leap, side aerial, and a tuck full. Looks like she missed her second foot at the end of that side aerial there, so didn't quite get it. If she didn't get on the beam, then she couldn't push off of it in order to get the height she needed for her tuck full dismount. Looking at Bridgeport's floor scores, they actually ended up with a 47.75 unofficially. Kelly Tereshko started with an 8.85, Gabby Kistner with a 9.6, Kelly Acock with an 8.95, Juliana Rowland with a 9.7, Crystal Gwynn with a 9.725, and that big floor team for Maya Reimers with a 9.8 to finish up. Take a look at that beam routine. Series. Beautifully done. Back handspring, back layout, step out, back layout, step out. You see a lot of two-element flight series in collegiate gymnastics. You don't see a lot of three-element flight series, and that was done very nice. Followed by a switch sleeve, tuck three quarters. Judges will be looking for a little bit bigger split there. Her full turn. Round off 1.5 dismount. After some struggles on beam there, that is a nice routine for Temple to finish up with. Temple starts with a full wolf turn on the beam, which was a little bit off. She came up a little bit high and then does her back layout step out and unfortunately has to take a fall. Looks like she will try that again for her flight series. Back. Standing layout step out, layout 2 feet. Extremely difficult. Done nicely the second time around. Split jump, sheep jump, just missed that second foot there a little bit. It looks like Temple on beam was led by that last beam routine scoring a 9.8. Ariana Kostrense scored a 9.65. Taylor Newland scored a 9.65 as well. And then Delaney Guerin with a 9.275, Jordan Oster with a 9.075, and Jackie Turback for a 9.025, which will give them an unofficial team score of 47.45 to finish their first rotation. That'll do it for the first rotation. We will head to the second rotation where Bridgeport will be on vault. University of New Hampshire will be on bars, Pittsburgh will be on beam, and Temple will be on floor.
All right, babe, let's hear it for these handstanders are doing their job. Arms don't seem to be getting tired. This is a pretty good crew out here. Come on, babe. enjoy the Pittsburgh lineup, and we have our winner! We have our winner!
As teams finish up, judges will take control of their events, and we will get started on our second rotation.
Judges, please take control of your events. Leading off in rotation two, on vault for Bridgeport, Bio Drivers. On cars, 31H, Danielle Good. On B for Pittsburgh, Olivia Miller. And on score for Temple, Erica Hughes.
We will look at all four teams to start here, the second rotation. Great starts for all the teams. Danielle Doolin for New Hampshire hit a nice bar routine, a little bit of leg form deductions, maybe a couple slightly missed handstands, but overall a solid routine. Freshman Olivia on beam there. Took a little fall. Getting back up. Hopefully finishing strong. Her foot slipped on that front aerial. She straddled the beam a little bit. Did not look enjoyable. Finishes with a side aerial layout fall. It was a beautiful routine otherwise. On vault, we will be looking at senior Brianna Zane. On bars, we will be looking at junior Ava Watkins. On beam, we will move to sophomore Haley Breckwald. And on floor, we will look at Jordan Oster. High straddle Jaeger for Ava on bars. Slight leg separation on the blind change there, but a nice straddle back to handstand to the low bar. She gears up for her dismount. Finishes with a double layout. Slightly short on the dismount, took a slight hop forwards, but a nice routine for Ava. Jordan Oster. She is a sophomore from Perry Hill, Maryland, and she has a career high of a 9.825 on floor. Starts with a double tuck done nicely. Brianna Zine's vault is a souk tuck full done beautifully. A slight hop to the side, but chest was up and everything was high and clean on that vault. Beam will get a look at sophomore Haley Breckwald. Again, she is the reigning Eagle Rookie of the Year from last year. And after the slight mishap for Olivia to start on beam, Pittsburgh will hopefully be looking to drop that score. She starts with a beautiful front aerial, back handspring step out as her flight series, done beautifully. Whip half front full, just didn't quite get the punch she needed on floor. Haley just did a beautiful sheep jump on beam. Super difficult, your eyes come completely off the beam. And she did it with no problem. So senior Maritza Fuch on vault. And on bars, we will look at junior Riley Freeling from Southington, Connecticut. She has a career high of a 9.875. Nice vault for Bridgeport. She did take a big hop back at the end, but overall the height and the shape in the Yurchenko full was done nicely. Riley missed the vertical on that handstand there. But recovers with a nice piked Jaeger. And you can see she's just a little bit shy on all of her handstands. The judges are looking for that and definitely will take some deductions there. But she finishes with a beautiful double layout. On beam, we will look at freshman Kylie Robitin from Sudbury, Pennsylvania. She scored a 9.675 last week. And on floor, we will look at freshman Taylor Newland from Powell, Ohio, who also scored a 9.675 on floor last week. Coming up on vault for Bridgeport is freshman Crystal Gwynn from Newport Richey, Florida. And she did a nice Yurchenko full as well. Look at Taylor Newland. Bars, we're going to get to take a look at one of my favorite routines, sophomore Lauren Diggin. She has a career high of a 9.925, and she starts with a very unique combination here. Finds the handstand, here's that combo. She does a hop full so nicely right on top of the bar to a gingbear right away. Finds a handstand there. To a straddleback handstand. Finishes with a double layout stuck. What a beautiful routine for Lauren. On vault, we have freshman Juliana Rowland, who scored a 9.75 last week. Taylor Newland is finishing up her floor routine. And on beam, Kylie is finishing up her beam routine. A nice tuck front full. A nice routine for Pittsburgh on beam. Bars for New Hampshire, we will get our first look at freshman Haley Louis. This routine is absolutely beautiful. She has beautiful lines, and when hit well, this routine has the potential to get a really, really big score. On vault, Bridgeport will finish up with sophomore Gabby Kistner, who has a career high, or has last week scored a 9.775. On beam, we will be looking at senior Lucy Brett, who has a career high of a 9.9. And on floor, we will be looking at sophomore Monica Servideo. So that beautiful release move Haley started with. Toe handstand. This So slight leg separation there, but finds a handstand on the shoot over. Unique here, she casts and does a blind right away to a front giant. And we'll just look for the dismount here. A hop backwards, but a beautiful routine for the freshman. Gabby's vault. Kurchenko layout half, a great shape. Just over rotate when it's a blind landing like that, it's hard to find your landing, so she did take a couple big steps at the end. Overall done nicely. And anchoring on bars for Wildcats is senior Danielle Mulligan, who has a career high of a 9.95. Again, a potential for a really big score for her and for the Wildcats. She has an extremely difficult routine. She does something called an eagle grip giant into a Pike Jaeger immediate overshoot. And when she does it well, it is flawless. Nice flight series for Lucy over on beam with a side aerial back handspring, unique. One and a half front layout done nicely on floor. Danielle's bar routine. Finds a handstand there. Here is that eagle grip, extremely difficult. Looks like she just couldn't quite get her hand on that eagle grip giant. And so unfortunately had to stop her routine, jump down. And she will look to finish strong. Next up on beam for Pittsburgh will be sophomore Jordan Cesarini from Millier Place, New York. Last week she scored a 9.6. And on floor for Temple will be freshman Ariana Castrance, from Waldorf, Maryland, and she scored a 9.85 last week. Double layout to start on floor. Done nicely. She did have to take a step out of bounds, which is a deduction. But once she learns to control that, that is a great start. Choreography is awesome. She's having a lot of fun with it. Round off whip half, front half. A fun routine. Unfortunately, Jordan did fall off in her flight series there on beam. She'll be looking to finish very strong here. Straddle jump three quarters, her required jump series. Done very nice. Front toss. Solid. And a gainer pike dismount stuck. So she did finish solid. Unfortunately, that was another fall for Pittsburgh on beam. So they will have to count a fall at this point. On floor, we will take a look at senior Indy Anderson from Allendale, South Carolina, and she scored a matched her career high last week with a 9.85. India will finish here for Temple on floor, and finishing up on beam for Pittsburgh will be senior Brittany West from Claremont, Florida. She scored a 9.8 last week, but has a career high of a 9.85. A little extra pressure on her, as there were two mistakes previously in the lineup, so she will be looking to handle that pressure with a hit routine. With a big jump series, leap series, switch half to a straddle jump, done beautifully. Nice big split. Flight series backhands from layout step out. Done nicely. She looks like she could have taken a bobble check there, but put that foot down and said, I am not wobbling. Nice switch leap three quarters or a switch side half. Very unique. India starts with a big double pike on floor. Having some fun with her choreography too. And Brittany finishes with a round up, 1.5. 13 they were looking to finish with on beam over there. A front full through to a double full. Extremely difficult. India does it well. Temple's having so much fun with their floor routines. Finishes with a front 1.5, a Rudy. Such a fun floor routine, done so nicely. A great way for Temple to finish up on floor. taking a look at the unofficial scores, it looks like on bars for the Wildcats, Lauren Diggins scored a 9.825, Danielle Doolin with a 9.525, Riley Freeling with a 9.75, Haley Louis with a 9.7, and Abel Watkins with a 9.625. Unofficially ending with a 48.425. On vault for Bridgeport, Maritza Fuch started with a 9.7, Crystal Gwynn with a 9.725, Gabby Kistner with a 9.6, Juliana Rowland with a 9.55, Brianna Zine with a 9.725, and Maya Reimers with a 9.375 to finish with a 48.3. Waiting for the last couple of beam and floor scores. But on beam, Haley Breckwald with a 9.85, Lucy Brett with a 9.875, Kylie Robiton with a 9.825, Jordan Cesarini with a 9.15, and Olivia Miller with a 9.1. On floor for Temple, Ariana Castrance with a 9.6, Erica Fuchs with a 9.55, Taylor Newland with a 9.55, Jordan Oster with an 8.9, and Monica Servidio with a 9.725. Again, waiting for a couple of beam and floor scores. The last beam routine from Brittany West got a 9.875, and that last floor routine from India Anderson got a 9.8. Meaning that unofficially, after two rotations, New Hampshire is in second place with a 96.6, just edged out by Pittsburgh with a 96.65, followed by Bridgeport with a 96.075 and Temple with a 95.675. Again, competition is close here, halfway through. New Hampshire will head to beam, where they will be led off by junior Riley Freeling. Pittsburgh will be heading to floor, where they will be led off by sophomore Jordan Cesarini. Temple will be heading to vault, where they will be led off by sophomore Tori Edwards. And Bridgeport will be heading to bars, where they will be led off by freshman Juliana Rowland. Take another look at some of these routines. Ready for our third rotation. On floor will be sophomore Jordan Cesarini. On vault, Tori Edwards. On beam, Riley Freeling. And on bars, Juliana Rowland. Big double tuck on floor to start. Beautiful control. Riley starts her beam routine. Back handspring layout step out, so solid. Slight little wobble there on her full turn. A front toss in a pike shape. You see the front toss in the tuck shape a lot. You don't see it in a pike shape a lot. And Riley added that to her routine this year. It looks beautiful. Her jump series finished with a double tuck there. Answering front full, front layout, half straddle jump on floor. And a gainer full dismount for Riley. Stuck landing and a great way for the Wildcats to start on beam. And a great floor routine from Jordan on floor as well. On vault for Temple, we will look at junior Yasmin Eubanks from Mitchellville, Maryland. On bars, we will move on to senior Kelly Acock. On beam, we will move on to freshman Hannah Baddock. And on floor, we will move on to senior Lucy Brett, who is having herself quite the meet so far today. Nice Yurchenko layout full on vault. A slight step sideways, but great shape. Good height and distance. And it started with a full turn and then did a nice front tuck. Again, looks like she could have wobbled there, but she said, I am not letting that happen. Followed by a back handspring layout step on, slight little bobble. She tried to cover it up. Double tuck on floor to start. Nice to catch up on bars. A sheep jump for Hannah on beam again, one of those skills that she takes her eyes completely off of the beam. Very difficult. She finishes with a front full and a stuck landing for the freshman on beam. A great 1-2 start for Wildcats on beam. Ready for her last tumbling pass. Front 1.5, slight pike down on the landing there. A little out of control, so she takes a hop, but the rest of the routine was done very nicely. On vault for Temple is junior Jasmine Estrella. She has a career high of a 9.85. She is capable of a big score. And a huge score for the freshman on beam with a 9.9. incredible. Next up on beam, we'll see junior Emma Weiner. She has a career high of a 9.75, has only been in a few beam lineups. And is ready to show us what she's got. A nice Yurchenko full on ball. Emma starts with a solid handspring layout step out. Followed by a cat leap, front toss. Slight little bobble there, but covers it up. On floor, we will be looking at freshman Olivia Miller. And on bars, I believe this is senior Tamara Powell Brown. A nice Shaposhnikova to immediate clear hip, a very difficult bar connection there. Double pike on floor. And it's another stuck landing on beam for Emma. Looks like teams are really turning it on here in the third rotation. Second tumbling pass, a double tuck on floor. On vault, we're looking at junior Jaylene Everett, who has a career high of a 9.875, capable of big score here. Yurchenko full done nicely. Slight little hop back. But a great ball. So a little short on the front layout, going into the front layout full on floor for Olivia. So she didn't quite punch through her toes, didn't get enough height, and landed a little short on that front full. Finishing up the vault lineup for Temple will be freshman Ariana Costranza. It looks like back-to-back 9.9s for the Wildcats on beam as Emma Weiner scores a career high 9.9 as well. Coming up on floor is sophomore Sophie Bohenik. And I believe on vault that Ariana does a Yurchenko 1.5, which comes from a 10-0 start value. I think I saw her warm it up and it was done so nicely. Done very nicely. Again, a small little hop, but starts from a 10-0, and that was a huge vault. Beam, we're looking at senior Courtney Bondanza, who has a career high of a 9.875. She starts with a front aerial, back handspring. What I love about Courtney's beam routine is that she looks calm, cool, and collected up there. Everything she works through is so smooth and relaxed, which is a very difficult thing to do when you're on 4 inches of wood. Front toss to a beat jump. Nice job for Courtney. Switch leap, straddle, quarter. Back leg was a little bit low on that switch leap, looking for a little bit bigger split. And she does the moonwalk as she gets ready for her dismount. Cartwheel, gainer, full. 4 in a row stuck dismounts, and that is what you were looking for in a beam lineup. Oh. Here is Sophie on floor. She scored a 9.75 last week. That another career high as Courtney Bondanza scores a 9.925 on beam. we'll get a look at freshman Haley Louis on beam. A very difficult beam routine. If she connects everything, she will do a front aerial, back handspring layout, step up, connected. She will also do a side aerial, and she will also do a side summy. Again, her long lines carry over, and she is beautiful to watch on this event. Front aerial, back handspring, layout step out. Small little bobble there, but still very difficult connection, and she does it well. Side aerial, solid. Side semi, again, super solid. Here's where she stands out. These leaps are gorgeous. She goes above 180, split jump. Shows off her gracefulness there as she gets ready for her dismount. Round off 1.5, 5 duck landings in a row. Unbelievable. That is the way you build a beam lineup. The little things count. Beautiful straddle Jaeger, lots of height there. Finds a good handstand on the high bar. Shoot over handstand, just slightly shy of vertical. Nice handstand on high bar there. Upline change full to a double tuck and a stuck landing. What a beautiful bar routine for Bridgeport. We are looking at junior Alicia Petrakis from Grove City, Pennsylvania, and she has a career high of a 9.875, so could be a big score here for Pittsburgh on floor. And anchoring the beam lineup for the Wildcats is senior Danielle Mulligan, who has a career high of a 9.925 as well, so could be a big score here for the Wildcats. She starts with backhand spring layout step out, slight little bobble. Double turn for Danielle there. Unique, makes her stand out. It is a requirement to do a turn. Danielle takes it to the next level by doing that double turn. To a front toss. Switch leap, 2 foot split jump. Danielle finishes with a gainer. 6 stuck dismounts on beam. I mean, my goodness. A nice floor routine for Alicia on floor. Following a big score of a 9.85 on bars. A little shy of that handstand. Double tuck dismount. Look at that beam rotation. 49.425 unofficially without Danielle Mulligan's finishing routine there, which they're still working on the score. Absolutely amazing third rotation for the Wildcats on beam. And as Danielle Mulligan's score comes in as a 9.85, again, New Hampshire scored a 49.425, which sets a school record for the Wildcats on beam. This will be sophomore Claire Hanford, who will be doing an exhibition routine. Finishing up on floor for Pittsburgh is senior Charlie Spivey from Enterprise, Alabama. She matched her career high with a 9.85 last week. She is following Alicia's 9.775. Starts with a very difficult 2.5 twist to a punch front. Having a lot of fun with her floor routine. Pass, double tuck, a little bit low on the landing there. Her chest was slightly down. She will get a small deduction for that. She gets ready for her last tumbling pass. Rudy, and a beautiful floor routine for Pittsburgh's last and final spot on floor. We will wait to hear of the last floor routine for Pittsburgh, reviewing those scores of the huge 49.425 school record-setting beam rotation for the Wildcats. Was Hannah Baddock with a 9.9, Courtney Bondanza with a 9.925, Riley Freeling with a 9.85, Haley Louis with a 9.85, Danielle Mulligan with a 9.85, and Emma Weiner with a 9.9. For Bridgeport on bars, Kelly Acock scored a 9.675, Catherine Duran with that huge 9.85, Maritza Fuch with a 9.75, Tamara Powell Brown with a 9.7, Juliana Rowland with a 9.2, and Kelly Tereshko with a 9.75. For Temple on vault, Ariana Costranze scored a 9.75, Tori Edwards with a 9.625, Jasmine Estrella with a 9.725, Yasmin Eubanks with a 9.6, Jaylene Everett with a 9.75, and Monica Servidio with a 9.725. On floor, still waiting for Charlie Spivey's floor score, but Sophie Bohenick scored a 9.725, Lucy Brett with a 9.675, Jordan Cesarini with a 9.775, Olivia Miller with an 8.975, and Alicia Patricus with a 9.775. And it looks like Charlie Spivey ended up with that floor rotation with a 9.825, giving Pittsburgh a total of 48.775 on floor. After the third rotation, the Wildcats are in first place with a 146.025 after that huge beam rotation. University of Pittsburgh is in second place with a 145.475. Bridgeport in third place with a 144.8, and Temple in fourth place with a 144.05. In our last rotation, New Hampshire will head to floor, Bridgeport will head to beam, Pittsburgh will head to vault, and Temple will head to bars. That will finish up the third rotation, and teams will head to their fourth rotation where they will begin their touch shortly. Started with our fourth rotation here. Again, we are looking at Delaney Cahill for Bridgeport, Allie Kusick for New Hampshire. We will be looking at Charlie Spivey from Pittsburgh and Daisy Todd from Temple. Looks like four solid routines to start our fourth rotation. Next on ball, we will be looking at freshman Olivia Miller. On bars, we will be looking at sophomore Delaney Guerin. On beam, we will be looking at senior Maritza Fuch. And on floor, we will look at senior Nicole O'Leary. Chamber layout half, a little bit low on the landing, but able to stay on her feet. On floor, Nicole will start with an extremely unique pass. She does a run, punch, double front, which is an E pass, extremely difficult to land. And a stuck landing for Temple on bars. A great routine for Bridgeport on beam, just a little bit shy on that dismount. Tried to cover it up, tried to take a step backwards, but unfortunately did take a fall there. Up for Pittsburgh on vault will be junior Devin Herbine. She has a career high of a 9.85. Up next on bars for Temple will be sophomore Monica Servideo. On beam for Bridgeport will be sophomore Gabby Kistner. And on floor, we are waiting for a score for Allie, and then we will be able to get started on Nicole's floor team. Gabby mounts beam, and Devin gets ready for vault. Korchenko layout full. A little close to the bar there for Monica on her Tkachev, able to stay on. A nice dismount off of bars, double layout, beautiful. Maybe a slight movement of the feet. Left hand turn layout step up for Gabby on beam. She has a solid routine going so far. And sophomore Haley Breckwald getting some last minute advice from her coach before she gets ready for her vault. And the judges are ready for Nicole to start her floor routine. Here goes Nicole, that extremely difficult pass. Unfortunately, does sit it down. Sometimes that happens when you have to wait a really long time. She could have gotten a little cold, wasn't totally ready. On vault for Pittsburgh is junior Alicia Petraikis. On beam for Bridgeport, we will look at freshman Juliana Rowland. And on bars, we are looking at sophomore Tori Edwards for Temple. She starts with a Tkachev. I think she hit her feet on the bar there, just didn't get quite enough height that she was looking for. A little over on the shoot over there. Hit her feet on the low bar too, which will be a deduction. And shy on that last double tuck for Nicole. A nice vault for Alicia. Looks like she turned a little bit early on the vaulting table, but got huge height and a very clean landing. Beautiful handspring layout step out on beam for Juliana. Cat leap, side aerial, and she fights to stay on. Great job from the freshman. switch leap, split jump, back tuck, difficult connection. She does it nicely. On vault, we will be looking at sophomore Sophie Bohenick. On bars, we will move on to freshman Ariana Castranzi. As Juliana finished up her nice beam routine, we will move on to sophomore Catherine Doran. And on floor, we will look at junior Emma Weiner, who is coming off her career high of a 9.85 last week. Take a look at Emma's floor routine. She should be starting with a difficult E tumbling pass, a full end, and she does it beautifully. Nice and controlled landing. Straddle jump full, wolf 1.5. A nice routine for Temple on bars. And a great second pass for Emma. Emma is so powerful. She looks like she has springs in her legs. She gets so much height on everything that she does. A nice wolf turn for Catherine on beam. As Emma gets ready for her last pass. She finishes with a beautiful double tuck. What a great meet for Emma today. A career high on beam, a great floor routine, and an exhibition vault that is showing she is ready for that vault lineup. Finishing up on bars for Temple will be junior Jasmine Estrella. She has a career high of a 9.925. Looking at Catherine Duran. Nice side aerial. And she fights to stay on her feet on the dismount. Getting ready for Flora's senior, Danielle Mulligan. She has a career high of a 9.9. Danielle has a unique routine. She showcases her beautiful artistry. Nice Tkachev for Jasmine on bars. Beautiful pack salto. Fight. Trying to do that half pirouette, having a little bit of difficulty. Unfortunately, has to take a fall there. As I was saying, Danielle has beautiful artistry, beautiful lines. She has unique dance. Starting off right here with a difficult turn combination. She does a triple turn to a backwards double turn, a little bit of a fall out of that. Starts with her first tumbling pass here. Round off 1.5 front layout, done nicely. On bars, Jasmine will finish up her routine. And on beam for Bridgeport, we will be looking at sophomore Maya Reimers. A great job for Jasmine to finish so strong on bars. Step up, done nicely for Maya. And a nice side aerial to follow up. Danielle finishes with a front 1.5, a slight pike down at the end there, but a solid routine for Danielle on floor. difficult combination done nicely for Maya as she gets ready for her dismount. Round off. Double twist with a hop back. That should score nicely and was a great way for Bridgeport to finish their beam lineup. We will close out the meet looking at the last two Wildcats on floor. We will next be looking at sophomore Lauren Diggin, who has a career high of a 9.9. She has a unique and difficult routine as well. Just hoping to put it all together here. Exhibition routines for Temple on bars and Bridgeport on beam, and Lauren Diggin up on floor. She starts with the same tumbling pass that Emma started with, extremely difficult full in. And she sticks it cold. Done so nicely. Switch leap straddle full. She has a unique second pass here. She has a front half to a back full. Slight little step back there. Sky-high double tuck stuck again. Fantastic routine for Lauren on floor. That is the kind of control the judges are looking for on your landings. If you can stick it solid, that is exactly what they would like to see. Close out the meet with junior Ava Watkins. She has a career high of a 9.825, getting a last minute pep talk from Gail. And it looks like she will follow Lauren's 9.825 for her floor routine. With a wolf jump 1.5. Mm-hmm. starts with a unique series here. She goes a front 1.5 to a back layout step out, done so nicely. Her jump series here, switch leap, straddle jump. Teammates having a little fun with her on the sidelines. Second pass, a back 1.5 to a front half. Stretch jump. What a way to close out the meet for the Wildcats. On beam, Bridgeport finished with Delaney Cahill scoring a 9.825, Catherine Duran with a 9.575, Maritza Fuch with a 9.075, Gabby Kisner with a 9.8, Maya Reimers with a 9.825, and Juliana Rowland with a 9.75 for a 48.775. Pittsburgh finished vault with a 48.25, and Temple finished bars with a 47.8. Looks like unofficially Temple scored a 191.85. In third place was Bridgeport with a 193.575. In second place was Pittsburgh with a 193.725. And we will wait for Ava's score to get our final team result for New Hampshire. Again, New Hampshire highlighted by that school record setting 49.425 on beam. And it looks as though Ava scored a 9.85, which will bring the New Hampshire team score to a 194.925, I believe. We'll wait for official word on